Hello, my name is Cornelius Köll. Today I will show you how you can install privacyIDEA on Ubuntu 18.04 easily from the community repositories. The packages we will install now are meta packages which contain the complete setup. privacyIDEA stores the data in a MySQL database, runs in an Apache server as a Whiskey plugin, and also provides a radius interface via a free radius server. So we now will install the meta package which sets up the complete stack.
We follow the guideline and the documentation at privacyIDEA, read the docs.io. First, we have to fetch the signing key for the repository. I'm here at a naked, freshly installed Ubuntu 18.04 machine and fetch the signing key. Next step can be, if you want to verify that you actually have fetched the correct signing key, there are different commands for doing this in 16.04 or in 18.04. So we take the command for 18.04. And we can verify the fingerprint or compare the fingerprint. And it looks good so far. So you can be sure that actually the packages originate from us and are not modified. So now we can fetch the signing key or add the signing key to our keyring. And now your Ubuntu system actually trusts this PGP signing key. privacyIDEA for Ubuntu is available in packages for different distributions. We provide it for Xenial, so for 16.04 and for 18.04. We provide stable packages and we also provide a development repository. But in this scenario, we want to install a productive system. So we fetch the stable packages for Bionic for 18.04. We can use the command add apt repository that basically adds the this line to your apt repositories. So you see that we now fetched the packages for the privacyIDEA packages. Now, well, let's take a look at the documentation again. We can run an apt update, but this is already done internally. So we can update the repository definitions and also install the privacyIDEA packages. There are different privacyIDEA packages available. If we take a look at the available packages now, we see we have privacyIDEA, that which actually contains the code. We have privacyIDEA Apache 2, which is a meta package that installs all dependencies, starting from a MySQL server with the Apache server and configures the system accordingly. We have the same for Nginx. And we have a radius package. Please note that if we are now going to install privacyIDEA Apache 2. If you install this, it will configure the machine to run as a standard privacyIDEA system, which also means if you have any other applications on the system that are using the Apache web server, you will probably run into problems because this meta package will actually deactivate other web server configurations and activate the privacyIDEA configuration. So now we install the privacyIDEA meta package, which fetches all necessary components. And after this, we will also install the privacyIDEA radius package, because then we can also connect VPN servers or any other applications that actually authenticate users via the radius protocol to privacyIDEA. This is usually an easy way to add two-factor authentication to existing applications. Okay, the installation also creates a self-signed certificate, and now we also install the radius component. This is quite quick. The online documentation also tells you something about first steps to take. So basically, the only thing you need to do at the command line now is set an initial administrator password. You are using the tool pimanage to do this, which is used for very basic tasks on a database level. So privacyIDEA does not come with a default administrator with a default password, so you will never have the problem that you might have forgotten to change a default password. So I add an administrator, which in my case I will call super user. I'm asked for a password. Actually, the initial authentication against privacyIDEA is a single factor authentication against the web UI. You could change this later in the configuration to also authenticate with two factors against privacyIDEA. So now we installed the packages, we installed the system, we set the initial administrator, and now we are good to go to enter the web UI. When we now access the privacyIDEA system, we get a certificate warning because it is a self-signed certificate. But now we have the web UI of the privacyIDEA up and running, and we can log in to privacyIDEA with the administrator, with a super user we just created, with a password we just set. And now we are logged in, and you can start to configure and use privacyIDEA. So thank you for watching. If you want to know more about how you can use privacyIDEA, take a look at the linked videos.